Greetings, fencers. So I posted a video a little while ago about distance. It was just a short live talk about a later distance system that I like to use, but I had some good comments on it about some specific distances, so I actually wanted to make a video going through the primary sources on distance, in this case specifically about the Zettel. Every master has their own ways they discuss distance. We see Fiore have the incrassata, we see rapier systems tie tempo and motion, size to distance, and we see in later saber systems the term measure used, and is very specific about how the blades are touching, like you're actually measuring, which goes along with the art to science migration. Now before we dive in, there are three elements I want to bring up that affect distance. One is reaction time. How fast you can react will directly affect the distance that you can do a technique. Here you see Eduardo thrust. Luckily I was far enough because I only moved my sword after he had stopped. Here we can see my opponent in Nebenhut, but it's too big of a hand motion from there and not enough reaction time. I was able to strike before he moved the sword. The next element is height and weapon length. If you're a shorter fencer or using a significantly shorter weapon, you will not be able to copy and paste the exact advice and technique. You will first need to sneak into distance, plan around a bind, or use multiple steps. One of the simplest steps is to add the increase of the front foot prior to a step, or gather. It will telegraph, but you have to get there somehow. And the last element is fear. Having that idea somewhere in your head when you're wanting a serious exchange is, would I do that if it was my life? The goal of not getting hit shapes where you will stand, how you approach, and how you move through distances. We have a lot of prolonged exchanges inside distance in modern HEMA, primarily because we know our partner well, and what they will do, and we're not actually scared. That's not a bad thing to see exchanges like that, but it's important to recognize it. Now in the early Zettel sources, there is not an explicitly laid out distance format that we see later on. We do see Meyer add a little bit more and explains the beginning, middle, and end of fencing. Beginning encompasses the guards, the cuts, and the onset. The middle is handwork, binding, cutting round, and wrestling, and the end being the three forms of how to withdraw. We also see the same concept mentioned in the earlier 3227A source. Here learn the frequens modus, or constant motion, which secures your opponent in the beginning, middle, and end of all fencing according to this art and teaching. You should execute beginning, middle, and end in one rush without break and without being stifled by your opponent, and under no circumstances let him gain the opportunity to strike. This artistic concept was likely taught to all Liechtenauer students, but just didn't make it into writing enough. So it's something we should all be familiar with, but the only explicit details that I've found are with Meyer in 1570. It is still a very abstract form of distance and isn't quite a one-for-one answer to the question, so let's look into the Zettel sources and see what we find. Now I actually realized a little too late that this video would be too long, like 30 minutes if I put all the quotes for each distance. So here's the intro introducing the concept of beginning, middle, and end. Definitely let me know if you have found it quoted in other sources as well. The next episode will be about Zufechten. Thanks for watching, keep studying, keep practicing.
Oh, man, gets you killed.